गुड मॉर्निंग, नमस्ते। आई जेवीएन ज्योति कुमावत। टुडे आई एम गोइंग टू प्रेजेंट टॉपिक पोर्टफोलियो असेसमेंट विच इज़ फ्रॉम द कोर्स असेसमेंट ऑफ लर्निंग एंड फॉर द प्रोग्राम बीएससी बीएड फोर्थ सेमेस्टर। सो स्टूडेंट स्टार्ट फ्रॉम द मेन टॉपिक, व्हाट इज पोर्टफोलियो असेसमेंट। This is a purposeful collection of student work that has been selected and organized to show students' learning progress or to show sample of students' best work. This portfolio assessment can be used in addition to other assessments or the sole source of assessment. Some schools even use portfolio assessment as a basis for high school graduation. Now you can also define the portfolio in following ways. This is a collection of student work that has been selected and organized. This portfolio show student learning progress. This also show the sample of students' best work. And this also portfolio is not a scrapbook but a purposeful collection of anything worth considering. Now here are some purpose of portfolio, like to give students the opportunity to reflect on their growth over a period of time. Second, to use as a basis for assigning grades based on efforts. To use a basis for communication with your parents as placement, whenever we require any placement and entrance examination, then these portfolio work better for us. Now, what do portfolio contain? There are some features that can contain sample of independent work, evaluation by teachers, peer, self, reflection on the growth over a period of time, may be used for instructional purpose and may include various stages of products, various drafts. In this also, finished portfolio like sample of best independent work, evaluation by teacher, peer, sample organized according to some systems like creative writing, scientific writing, research work, that all are contained in that portfolio. Usually used to provide a summative evaluation and standard format. Is now different purpose of portfolios are as follows. All content in a portfolio must be linked to the learning objective outcomes. Next, in addition to learning objective, there are many general purpose of portfolios: enhancing student learning, more emphasis on student reflection. Other purposes are assigning grades, displaying current achievements, demonstrating progress, showcasing student work, documentation, show finished work, and show work in progress. Now, here are some characteristics of instructional purpose in portfolio. Focus is on development of self-evaluation skills. Teacher and students must meet to discuss evaluation. In addition to improving instruction, the goal is to help student internalize criteria for excellence, can be used for student-directed conference with parents. Focus is on evaluation of student work. It's in it entries and clarify accomplishment. Teacher should provide student with clear guideline about content of portfolio and scoring criteria. If used to assess program goals, the content and organization of portfolio must be highly standardized. Now, there are some advantages to making the portfolio. First, it can monitor the learning progress of student over a given period of time. Next advantage you can observe is it can show the student best work. It can compare the student best work from the past to present. Other advantages are like it can develop reflective learning. It can provide documentary evidence of learning to teacher, parents, and your stakeholders. It can foster teacher, student, as well as parents, child collaboration in the teaching learning process. So these are some advantages. Now we come to the some limitations or disadvantage of portfolio. It is cumbersome to collect and store portfolio entries. It is time consuming to make a portfolio, and it may create resistance on the part of the students. So this is complete our portfolio assessment. I hope you are satisfied with my lecture, which is powered by Jyoti Vidyapeeth Women's University. If you have any query, then please comment in comment box. Thank you.